Welcome to the Groza in PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds. Today, we're going to check out this beast of a weapon. Hard to find, but in the right hands, it's a very dangerous gun, especially when you have two of them. The first thing that I can tell you about the Groza is that you're going to have to fight for it. The airdrops became a lot more popular since the release of the June patch because everybody wants to play with the Groza, and this is the only place where you might find it. Before the patch, I usually saw one, maybe two guys, and that's it. Now I sometimes see more than six. My advice is to make sure that you get there first and that you also make sure that you're the first guy to get out of there, because the enemies will just keep on coming. Sometimes it feels like a game of zombies where wave after wave comes after you. I also found out that you can ram the airdrop with your vehicle and that it will move just far enough to kill the guy who is hiding behind it. Unfortunately, I found out the hard way and my time with the Groza was very limited to say the least. Sometimes you'll be able to move the airdrop, other times this is not possible, but I haven't figured out the reason yet, so be careful if you decide to use this tactic, but make sure that you keep your distance when you are the one who is picking up the Groza. And then there are times when you're finally alone with an airdrop and the thing just disappears. So yes, it takes some effort before you can play with the Groza. I will compare it with one other assault rifle because I don't want to overload you with stats, but I will show you a big chart that gives you a perfect overview of all the important information regarding all the assault rifles, and I will also upload that chart on Patreon as well. The Groza is a selective fire, Russian bullpup assault rifle chambered for a 7.62mm round. It can deal 48 damage, which is a lot. In fact, it can deal exactly the same amount of damage as the AKM, so we will have a direct comparison between the Groza and the AKM. The initial bullet speed is 715 meters per second, which is identical to the AKM's initial bullet speed. The magazine capacity is 30, same as the AKM. And the zero range goes up to 400 meters. Again, the same as the AKM. Are you starting to see a pattern here? Well, that's because of the fact that the Groza and the AKM are extremely similar. The main difference lies in the time between shots. The Groza is a clear winner with only 0.08 seconds between shots compared to 0.1 seconds. This means that it can fire 750 rounds per minute and the AKM can only fire 600 rounds per minute. It can do that in single fire or fully automatic. The reload time is terrible though. It will take exactly 3 seconds for an empty reload and 2.25 seconds for a reload with bullets left. The Groza isn't the easiest weapon to use when you look at the spread, because it also has to deal with a base spread of 6, which is higher than the spread of all other assault rifles. Since the initial damage is the same as the AKM, you will also need the same amount of headshots, body shots, and arm or leg shots to kill. Let's take a closer look at our chart. I will build it up step by step, and in the end you will have a great overview of what it takes to kill with every assault rifle. Let's start with headshots. If your enemy isn't wearing a helmet, then all you need to do is to fire one bullet. If you found a level 1 or level 2 helmet, then fire two bullets. And the M16A4, the M416 and the SCAR-L need one extra bullet against the best helmet in Battlegrounds. This means that the Groza and the AKM only need two bullets to kill the same guy. This principle applies to body shots as well. If you are using the Groza or the AKM, then you generally have to fire one bullet less than if you were using any other weapon. This difference starts when your enemy is wearing a level 1 vest, and that is pretty much everybody who survived the first minute. If you decide to go for the arms or the legs, then you will need to fire 5 bullets to kill. This comes in handy against the best vest in PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds if you're using the M16A4, the M416 or the SCAR-L. If you want to know why, then please check out this video. As always, you can improve this weapon, but not that much. You can only attach a suppressor, so no flash hider and no compensator. You can also attach a red dot, a holographic sight, a 2x scope and a 4x scope. But you cannot attach anything better than a 4x scope. I found out in the middle of a game, and that's why I find it worth mentioning so that the same thing doesn't happen to you. The other attachments are a quick draw magazine, an extended magazine and an extended quick draw magazine. As you know, the third person shooting mode is terrible. The targeting mode is slightly better, and you will probably end up shooting off his ears. And ADS is much better with a snake-like bullet pattern. Let's take this a little bit further, and let's check out the effect of crouching. The third person shooting mode is now a lot more effective. Same goes for the targeting mode, and you will still shoot off his left ear. ADS is pretty much as good as it gets, with a perfect straight line. Lying down is much better, of course, but then you have to ask yourself, how many times are you going to be able to lie down before you start shooting at an enemy? And an even more important question, is it really a good idea to go prone in the first place, in a game like PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds? I'm actually interested in what you guys have to say about that, so please let me know in the comments. Overall, the Groza is a great weapon. Hard to get, but so rewarding to play with. Just for info, this is the new version of the Groza video. There were a few errors in the previous one, and I still don't know why I didn't see those myself, so thank you very much for pointing out those errors. I would like to offer you my apologies, and I hope that you can forgive me someday. Some of you didn't like the part about Patreon, so that was removed as well. I decided to remake that video so that I can give you a video that you deserve. I wasn't very clear when I spoke about Patreon, but I want this to be something for you guys. I want you to be able to choose which extra benefits and rewards that you get on Patreon. I proposed a few tiers, but everything is open to change, so please let me know what you want, and I will do my best to provide it for you. This was Fog of Gaming, thanks for watching, and I will see you in Battlegrounds.